Assalamu alaikum friends, my name is Muhammad and you are watching MEP Tech Tips channel. This is your channel. Today I have brought you a very nice video in regarding MEP support arrangement and installation. Prior to this foam board, you can see the pink color, that is isofoam board we call it, and this isoboard foam, I will tell you why we are fixing here isoboard foam, because this is a sensitive project, this is hospital based project, so we have some noise criteria to maintain in basement 1 and basement 2. Due to that noise criteria, the acoustic consultant designed in a way to fix this isoboard foam based on the health authority here. So the reason I have explained you for the isoboard foam installation in this project. And the next thing, I would like to ask a question to all of you. If you are in this position, you will allow main contractor to do first their installation isoboard foam, or you will complete your MEP support first? Which work would you prefer first, the civil work first or the MEP work first? You please explain in the comment box. And if you have any clarification or any brief explanation, you may give in the comment box. So in our opinion, or as per our experience, what we have taken decision, I will explain. There are some main reasons we have, in considering the main reasons, we have taken decision to complete our MEP support arrangement or installation prior to this isofoam board installation. The first reason is electrical. Why? I will explain. You know, these electrical boxes, the circular boxes, are very small, correct? And it will be installed in the during the slab casting. Okay, so first of all, what we have to do here, we have to check the circuits for the lighting circuits, fire alarm circuits, any whatever services for the electrical whichever we installed in the slab, we need to check it. The circuits are open or blocked by the concrete, so that is very important. You have to check, and if it is all cleared or there are some blockage, what you need to do, GI conditioning, because we are doing the open, so it is required GI conditioning, because it is not allowed PVC conditioning. GI conditioning is allowed open work, so as we did here. Now this is the first reason. For example, if we'll take another way, if you allowed main contractor to do first the isoboard foam installation on the slab, how we will find out the circular boxes? It's very difficult to us to find out the circular boxes, correct? We have to puncture each and every panel for this area to find out. So that will be a very big disaster to the civil contractor. So the main reason, that is the one main reason. As you see here, the GI boxes we extended from the slab to reach the thickness of isoboard foam. And another thing is the supports, the red rods, when we installed, we have a, you know, 2-inch maximum, 2.5-inch the length of our anchor bolts. So to install anchor bolt, for example, if they completed isoboard foam and you are going to install your anchor bolts for the MEP services, it's very difficult. You need to have very big drill bit, and then some special tools required, because we have also discussed with Hilti here, because we have all supports from Hilti. So we have been discussed with Hilti that this is the way, because we have this different kind of arrangement here for the slab. So in order to do our services before or after, what do you would you prefer, because they are expertise, so we have taken their also opinion to start our work. So they have also suggested it's quite difficult and long and take time taking job, so better you install your services first, and they can also easily install their support form, and we have to buy special tools for that. That is getting extra cost for us and for the project also. So we have to think cost wise, we have to think time wise, we have to think our labor, you know. So we have to think all aspects. So in thinking in all, in considering all aspects for the labor cost, time, and you know, tools, so we have taken decision to complete our MEP services. If anything damage during installation of support form, we can rectify it easily. So, and there will be some, you know, plus and minus, but we can manage. So this is the two main reasons we have taken decision to install our MEP services first, and then we will give clearance to main contractor to do their support form installation. So after support form installation, as you can see here, they have some mesh installation, and then after that emulsion paint for the finishes. So these are the finishes they have from the civil side. So after discussion with the client consultant, we have taken decision and we have installed our thread dots based on our approved coordination drawing. We have, you know, the heights in the coordination drawing for the each services. So based on that heights, maybe somewhere we required go up and down, so we have taken one standard length of our thread rod for the each services, and we cut it in that way, and we have installed. If we need to extend, we can extend. If we need to cut extra, we can cut extra also. So guys, let me know your comments, and give me big thumbs up, subscribe my channel, share to other people, and thanks for watching my channel. Jazakallahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum.